How's it going, everyone? My name is Adam, and this is the Mandriva Linux installation for the 2011, I think, 64-bit version. Yeah, 2011 PowerPack. I'm going to walk you through the installation. When you first boot it up, it will have a command line looking window. Simply hit enter at that screen and continue on. Now we are at our language. I'm English American, so I'm going to leave it at that and click next. Got a nice little window here. Read through the blah, 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 blah. Hit accept, next. Gonna detect your drivers, your keyboards. You can set that up however you like. I'm using default stuff. I don't want that. I'm using default. Hit next. Partitioning. Now I'm using this in a virtual box, as you see here, VMware, so I'm just gonna use up the entire free space. If you wanted to set up your own custom partitioning, you could do that. However, I'm not going to. Next. It's gonna format your disk and set it up. Again, if you had different partitions, that might take a little bit longer because you'd have to go through the partition editor. But for the most part, it's pretty simple and straightforward. I really like this installer compared to other things. Now, you can select, and this is a really cool part about the installer. You can select the different packages that you need to install in your installation of this version of Linux. So you can actually select each individual package, or you can just tell it which things to install. So right now it has the default stuff. And then you could install some development and game station things. You can install web and FTP stuff, mail, firewall, etc. I'm going to install gnome as the graphics environment because I like gnome. Hit next and it's going to install, and then we'll get to the configuration steps in just a minute once we get the installation out of the way. It's going to take quite a while to install it, but not a whole lot of time because it's Linux and it's fast and it's awesome. See? Maybe 2 minutes, so. After about an hour or two, you are finally able to set up your customization for Mandriva Linux. So we're gonna come up with a password, blah, 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 blah. You get to choose an icon. It doesn't let you browse, you just kinda click through them, so that's a bit annoying. Let's go with that so I don't have to worry about it. Real name, EposVox. Login name, EposVox. Password's gonna be the same because I wanna be the administrator. Caps lock is enabled. No, it's not. I just disabled it. You are behind, good sir. Behind, behind, behind. Okay. Then typing your password, click next. Username must be lowercase. Okay. That's stupid, but in case you didn't know, your username has to be lowercase. Hit next and gonna install some network packages. When Zed finishes downloading the networking drivers and things like that, you choose what kind of internet you're connecting to. Since I'm doing a virtual installation, it's wired Ethernet because that's what it emulates it as. Hit next. Etho, that's generally what you go with. Intel, blah blah blah. Next. Automatic IP, definitely. Get DNS from the router, which is, again, we're just emulating this, so all the defaults is kind of how it's supposed to go. And it's going to try and connect to the internet. Now, it may not be successful since I just started, or since it's just like pre-install virtual, or VMware sometimes holds things back. Oh, there we go. It does detect it. It finished. Now we're going to the bootloader. And then that screen will go away, and you'll be on your monitor settings. Now, you have a lot of different options given to you. However, for me, I gotta keep in mind that I'm running it in a virtual machine, so I kinda have to just pick something that's gonna fit within my screen. Now, I'd prefer widescreen, but it doesn't seem to have 1280 by 720, so I'm gonna go with this one. Hit next. It's gonna have all these configurations, things that I'm not gonna mess with. It's basically everything we've just reviewed. It's just a summary. Everything seems to be alright, so like I said, I'm not gonna mess with it. Hit next. It's gonna install your bootloader, and then it's gonna tell you your installation is complete. Congrats. Remove your disk. Blah blah blah, and you reboot. I'm gonna tell mine to reboot, and that's about it. You have installed Mandriva Linux on your system and/or virtual box.